What's going on, everybody? It's me, the owner of Danville Rare Productions on here on YouTube. I know it's been about a little over 2 years since my last upload in terms of like actual real world train stuff. Aside from like I just uploaded some trains and new era stuff that I've been working on that but sooner or later I was continuing working on that particular route, just been busy with like life and stuff. But I wanted to discuss about what the future of this channel is going to become from here on out. It's going to be focused on mostly trains and just train simulator stuff in general. For those that don't know me in person or just on a real personal level, I haven't been a rail fan in over 2 years in terms of going outside and actually doing it, like filming, recording, going trackside, listening to the radio, all that stuff. Well, it boils down to a couple of reasons why, though. The biggest reason is my grandfather, who was basically like the big inspiration and who got me into the trains, he passed away March of 2017, and I just wasn't feeling it without him being there, like being there, going out, just talking about how trains used to be and stuff, and that put a big damper on how I feel about railfan and stuff. And another big issue was the overall constant changing of the railroad. If you ever see my older videos, or even go to my rail pictures account, you see that there used to be like a lot more variety for like Class 1 railroads, such as high hood locomotives, Leaf's Power, all that standard Spartan Cab Power. All that good stuff. And not even just that, but also signaling, which is what you see right now in the photo. This was the plant in Etna in Riesel, North Carolina. This and pretty much all the Danville district, all old signaling has pretty much been gone as of basically as of like 2016, I would say. So now you go to railfan and now you're gonna see pretty much just Y cab power and safe transvaders, regardless of where you go. It's prevalent here in the main lines here on both NS and CSX. The next thing I wanted to talk about is what boils down to another reason why I pretty much gave up on it is precision railroading, aka PSR. It started with CSX, and we're seeing hump yards getting closed down, changing, and like trains, and a lot of the trains just up and went away. And now we've seen it with Norfolk Southern. I mean, we kind of saw it already when they changed the CEO, and they haven't done anything with 611 in a couple of years lately. And now we've seen it now, especially here in North Carolina on the Danville side. We lost trains. We lost a lot of trains out of northbound out of Linwood. And so we had trains like 158, one trains like 158 and 36Q are pretty much no more. Now you have 12R handling all the northbound traffic, and it tends to be over tonnage, and it also tends to be it can break down, so to speak, and it has mid DPUs and all that good stuff on it. So if I was to go out now to like Greensboro or somewhere to railfan, I won't see much action, so to speak. And whatever action's there is going to be a Y cab. There's going to be nothing but Y cabs or nothing but Amtrak, because there's a lot of Amtraks that run through here now. It's about eight a day between Greensboro and Charlotte. So it's something I wanted to get off my chest, because I haven't uploaded in so long, and people might be wondering where am I, what's happened, am I still alive? I'm alive and well, just working, doing all sorts of stuff, and I figure I changed to change I changed my focus from real world trains to trains with a Z, like simulators, like trains, Run 8, all that stuff. And sooner or later, maybe eventually model railroad. It's just I find it more interesting, and I can just do what I can do how I want. I can go back in time if I want to. Like if you see my trains videos around Salisbury, that's around the mid 2000s. That was when stuff was still like varied and it wasn't too much of signal changes. Places like Salisbury and Kannapolis have quiet zones now. It's a bunch of, a lot has changed in the past 10 years, 10 plus years. So I wanted to, and what another thing I wanted to discuss was, and people might be wondering, well, what about the non-train stuff that I have here on my channel? All my previous videos will stay. So feel free to go back to 4 or 5 years ago if you wish, or even older than that, and take a look at my videos. Everything was still remain on YouTube. Everything is safe and sound. But in terms of me uploading new footage for train stuff today, yeah, and sadly that it would not be happening anymore. I gave it up, ladies and gentlemen. I gave up, my friend. I don't have my SLR anymore. I don't have my camcorder anymore. I don't have my scanner anymore. But let's just say I haven't given up on trains. I still love trains. I like watching them and stuff. Especially when it comes to like the older, like 2000s and maybe late 90s stuff on YouTube. But I still, and I, and some occasionally I might still watch a video from like a busy place like Fostoria or something in terms of like recent stuff just to see how it is. But I don't really care much anymore. And so I decided to shift my focus elsewhere. But don't know, this is going on almost 7 minutes now. I'll go ahead and sign off here. And once again, I want to thank everybody, all my 1,000 plus subscribers for being there, supporting, watching the videos, spreading the word. Anyone else and anyone that I know personally, thank you all so much. And also in terms of the people that do know me, don't worry, we can still talk on social media. Some have my actual like phone number, so I'll still be open to talk and whatnot. In terms, I mean, it can be train stuff, it can be stuff from like 2 years ago, like, oh, remember this last job? I'm like, okay, cool. So, but yeah, that's gonna be in this video here. I figure I'd let everybody know what's been happening. So if anybody wants to know anything, you know, what's going on, if you know, or TLDR, basically, I decided to change things up. And this won't be any more railfan videos from me in terms of real life stuff. So, other than that, everybody, ladies and gentlemen, have a good day. See you later.